This season, they've scored 40 goals, 13th in the NLL. Teat gives it another shot. This one trickles through. Jeff Teat gets the Riptide on the board first. Final game of week 8, just 4 games this weekend. We had 2 great games last night. Shot rings off the pike. Did it go through, though? There was questions once again from Kiernan. He's had some tough luck here early, and there is the challenge flag from Dan Latissore. Glenn Clark in New England with the Black Wolves. Open communication, some tough conversations. Another one trickles in, the second for Jeff Teat.
Very, very well for the Riptide.
As they set up shot, working down the alley here. Digby, you can't miss him, the former tight end. And a rip from the outside. Laddie was looking for more of that for the Riptide, working inside out. There's the pick by Walker up top. John Piatelli, his father Jack. I'm sure watching John thrive, and the Firewolves are on the board. Connor Kelly, he ripped him from outside over the summer. Bottom right of your screen, Teat sets a strong pick off ball. There's Digby finding the man, cutting! What a finish! Larson Sundown!
Yeah, I feel like Riptide are playing with a little bit more sense of desperation, a little bit more kind of, we need to win this game. Continue to build confidence. And Dougie Jamison just hasn't looked sharp. And the defense has kind of played a little lackluster.
Goals, second quarter. Albany 2-2. New York is 0-4. And another rip from distance. Brett Hickey in Ontario. It actually says Yeti right below his mouth on the face mask. Hickey the pass, and Jeff Teat scores another. His third, a hat trick for Teat. The clock bleeds slightly, looking for a high percentage chance. Here's the dish to Kelly. Shoots and scores. Wolves now shooting on the left side of the floor. New York will come to our right. In the third, we're underway. And the Firewolves score to begin half number 2. So another infraction by Thornburg. Firewolves awarded possession. It's Tanner Thompson up top. Down 6, Thompson fires, and he scores! Just like that, it's a 5-goal game.
Yeah, we like to call that poison. If it's in front of the net, everybody needs to collapse. Oh, and a great move by Teat.
Oh, boy, Jeff Teat, number 5. You could see it developing. Scoring first 4 games last year compared to this year, the uptick in production is very evident. Here come the trailers on D. Nice pass, and the transition works to perfection.
Yeah, and
Kiernan. On February 18th for a box out cancer night. Secure your tickets today at albanyfirewolves.com. Ball still buzzing, short side, and Albany scores. Tanner Thompson again from distance. With the ball, his off-ball presence to create space and just organize everybody is huge. And also, Mernsey, they got the A on his chest this week. As that shot goes for Digby, or check it, Hickey, his second.
Yeah, second from long range.
Wolves look to return the favor. They pay a visit to the Riptide. Don't miss another interstate rivalry game, this time at Nassau Coliseum. Get your tickets now at NewYorkRiptide.com. His teammates.
Yeah, real quick, because he's on a whole new team a day before. As we were talking about, it's kind of like the money ball, and right there, maybe this kind of can spark the Firewolves. Break right pad.
Teat behind the back, flips it, and finally, Riley O'Connor gets a turn to score a goal. Jeff Teat gets him involved. 11 points for Teat. 6-5. O'Connor's got 5 now, 1-4.
It's about getting to the playoffs. You want to continue to build. You even look at like the Colorado Mammoth last year.
No question.
You know, hey, they weren't like, you know, the top of the list. But as the year went along, they started to figure out their mix. I mean, look at all the trades that are happening in the NLL.
Goals himself, Albany has 7 as a team. That is incredible. And Albany's on the board. John Piatelli goes low on Orleman and beats him.
But again, absolutely not enough in the tank tonight for the Firewolves.
We just missed it. We were discussing this before we went to break. They try to score from behind the goal. It trickles in for McArdle to make it 16-9.
You know, it's exciting time, you know, in the sport of lacrosse. And wow, look at that.
Nicely done. Walker's first of the night.